Day for science. It is an exciting day for the physics community here at the University of Maryland, where they are working on their own magnetic confinement fusion projects. We spoke with one professor who told us he has very close ties to this breakthrough announcement.
But just the fact that they achieved it, it is a very important milestone.
Carlos Romero-Talamas is an associate professor with UMBC and visiting professor with the University of Maryland, actively involved at the College Park campus's energy research facility. He tells us he was very excited to hear that his colleagues at the Lawrence Livermore National Library in California were able to produce a net energy gain through fusion.
It is very exciting because they finally solved or demonstrated that they can compress a capsule with laser energy, which is something that was in doubt for many years.
Romero-Talamas also has a special tie to the laboratory, studying there as a graduate student and scholar.
And of course, yes, we've been talking about that for years, right? And so it's gratifying to see that my colleagues at Livermore finally achieved that milestone.
While the Livermore experiment used lasers to achieve its goal, Romero-Talamas has a similar project in the works in College Park using magnets. Experts say real-world use of fusion is still decades away, but it's certainly a step in the right direction towards clean, carbon, and virtually waste-free energy. As an example, Romero-Talamas says power plants could run on minimal amounts of lithium instead of coal.
For a power plant that produces, say, a megawatt of power, you will need something like 9,000 tons of coal to power that power plant. With fusion energy, you will need about 2 kilograms. Or 4 kilograms, more or less, of deuterium and lithium.
And for a closer look at how all of this stuff works, we have some pretty exciting links on our website, WBALTV.com, and on our mobile app. In College Park, I'm Lowell Melser, WBAL TV 11 News.